is high. Deuce is low. Call it right and win the dough on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Bye, thank you. Welcome to Card Sharks, a game of decisions. And boy, do we have some decisions to make, because we left off in a sudden death position. We're going to have one question and one turn of the cards, and who knows, someone could become the champion on just that one card. We'll find out as right now we open the board and get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, start loading in the cards. And as they do that, we'll meet our Card Sharks. Hello, Corinne newcomer. Gee, with a name like newcomer, you're not the newcomer anymore. You've been here for a while. And again, remind us about yourself.
Okay, I'm from Hawaii originally, and I'm now living in San Clemente. I live a couple blocks from the beach, and I love the sun and the waves.
Good. Nice to see you again. And as our champ, you have won so far $15,100 on Card Sharks. Doing well. And our challenger, Yvonne Lockhart. Hi, Yvonne. Nice to see you again.
Thank you.
And again, would you remind us a little about yourself?
I'm a student, and I'm living by the ocean, and I'm enjoying flying my kite every day and laying out.
No, wait. What? Flying your kite?
Yes. I'm an avid kite flyer. I find it very peaceful.
Somebody told me that you like to fly kites, and they told me you made a trip to get a kite. Tell us about that quickly.
I went all the way to San Francisco to get a kite.
They didn't have it here?
No, I couldn't find one I liked.
Well, you are a kite flyer. Good luck in the match, and as you know, we play the best two out of three. When we left off, Corinne has won the first game in the match. So Yvonne needs this one to tie it up, right?
Sure do.
And as we left off, we are at sudden death. So let's quickly take a look at the board. Good luck to both of you. And each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go on the air. The upper cards, the red cards, to be played by the champion, Corinne. The lower cards, the blue cards, to be played by Yvonne, the challenger. The object of the game, to work your way across the board, predicting whether each card is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Before you can begin calling high-low on the cards, you must answer a high-low toss-up question. They're all based on a poll of 100 people, and they test your ability to judge human nature. Here comes little G2T2, and as you can see, there is just one question left. It is sudden death. Someone has to win on this play of the cards, and this question decides that control of the board. Yvonne, as we left off, the question goes to you. We asked 100 men, be honest, do you remember the name of the first person you ever made love to? How many men said they did?
Oh, I believe men are very romantic. I will say 75.
75. She says 75 out of 100 men remember the name of the first person they made love to. Higher or lower, Corinne?
I think men are as sentimental, so I think the number would be a little bit lower than that.
You say lower. If it is lower, you go to the board first. If not, it'll be Yvonne. You've got some agreement with the audience on that, Corinne. The actual number of men who remembered the name of their first lover is 77. It is not lower. Yvonne, you've got control of the board. Now, Yvonne, listen carefully. This is how we do it with sudden death. You have a king. You won the high-low toss-up question. You have the right to change it. It's a good card. You'd have to turn over all four cards correctly to win. If you make one mistake, the game belongs to Corinne. However, you have control. You can force Corinne to play off the jack, which she cannot change. She would have to turn these four cards over correctly, or the game is yours. It's your decision. You need this game to tie. Who's going to play it?
Corinne. Yeah. I'm going to pass.
Corinne.
Yes.
Kind of figure that whoever won it was going to make the other one play it. Corinne, this is it. If you can turn over four cards here, you remain the champion and get another crack at the money cards. If you cannot do it, we've got a tie, and we go to the tiebreaker. Start calling them, Corinne. What is this card?
Okay, the next card will be lower.
Lower than a jack. Remember, if it's another jack, you lose. It must be lower. It is a seven. You're one quarter of the way there.
Okay, I'm going to go with the odds, and I think the next card will be higher.
Higher than a seven. It's an eight. You're halfway there.
Okay, I think the next card is going to be lower.
Lower. Lower than an eight. It is a two. One card to go.
Okay, the next card will be higher.
Higher. If this is higher, she remains the champion, and Yvonne's strategy backfires for the win. Higher than a 2. It's a 9. Did it again. Yvonne,
thank you.
You played it right. It's just she got great cards.
Yes,
thank you for joining us, Yvonne. You're a fine player. Thank you. Corinne, come on down here with me, and we will right now get set up for the money cards. So far, Corinne, you've got $15,200, and we're going to go to the money cards right now. Congratulations. Did you think you were going to make that comeback?
No, I didn't think it happened
off. She put the pressure on, and you were equal. All right, let's see if we can add to your money right now. We're bringing out the little board there. And you're going to pop up on the podium and play it. You ready? All right. Good luck. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on up, Corinne. You've been up here before. You know how to do it. You won $200 in the game and $100 a game, and that's yours to keep. Now we're going to give you new money to play with, and this time you're going to bet that money. Starting on the bottom line with $200. Bet that as you wish on these three cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money. And again, it's your decision how you bet it. $50 minimum bets until you get to that top card, the big bet. There you must bet at least half the money. You've been doing well. Let's do it again. Ready? Here's $200 to start with. And as always, a choice of two base cards, starting with a 10. You want to play that 10? You want to change it?
I think I'd like to change it.
You'll change it. This one you must play, so I hope it's a better card.
Okay.
It is a 4. It is a better card. All right. Corinne, you've got $200 and a 4. Call this card.
I'm going to bet the whole thing that the next card will be higher.
Whole thing. Remember, if it's another 4 you lose, as in the game, it must be higher than a 4. $200, higher than a 4. Oh, it's another 4. That's all right. You're not out of it yet. Remember, we mentioned the other level. We're going to take that 4 and move it up here and give you that other $200 of betting money. You can still build it up because you've got 4 cards to go.
Okay.
What do we do with that 4 and $200?
I'll bet the whole thing again that the next card will be higher.
Right, 2 of them are gone. Got to be some other cards in there. $200. Higher than a 4. And, of course, if you bust now, it's all over. Higher than a 4? Oh, no! If you had gone high-low, getting to that 3 would have been great, but boy, the way you busted, it didn't work out. But you're still the champion. Come on down here, Corinne. You don't mind losing occasionally.
I don't mind.
But you're doing great. The $15,200 will be the new challenger right after this.
Raver.
Hello there.
Dawson.
Survey said.
The Long Mike.
That is absolutely correct.
The Longer Kiss.
I've gotten aroused.
2 originals, 2 hours.
The lunatics have taken over the asylum.
Match Game and Family Feud together again. Today at 4, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Well, Corinne, the cards were going good for you for a while, and not that time with the money cards. That's a surprise. You get another 4.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
that's...
What? Still a little stunned with that one.
Yeah.
But you're still here as the champion with over $15,000 won so far. You ready to meet a new challenger?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, Janice, if you will, start dealing out the cards, 2 brand new decks of cards. And as Janice deals them out, we will bring out our next player on Card Sharks. Hello, Ellen Sander. Nice to meet you. Good to have you here. Tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm a senior at UCLA, graduating with a BA in economics, and will be working as an executive trainee with a major department store in June.
Oh, you got your work all cut out for you as soon as you get out.
I start early, yeah.
That's the way to do it. Nice to have you here with us. Good luck in the match, Ellen.
Thank you.
You'll be playing the lower cards, the blue cards, as Corinne, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. And we'll start with a question to you, Corinne. We asked 100 married men. Now, if you could have your choice, which would you rather have, a new job or a new wife? How many men said they'd rather have a new wife?
Well, I hope that it wouldn't be too many. So I'm going to say that 25 would rather have a new wife.
Just 25 men out of 100 say they'd rather have a new wife than a new job.
Lower. No. I think it's definitely lower.
Definitely lower. Little agreement there with the audience. The actual number of men who said they'll keep their job but they want a new wife is... 17, it's lower. Ellen. Ellen, we'll take a look at your base card for this game, and you have an 8.
Change it.
Change
That's
it,
terrible.
Yes. You won the question. You can change it. 2, a 3.
Oh, good. Right. Okay. Okay, it has to be higher. It has to be higher.
Higher than a 3. It's a 5.
I'm going to
So you got higher. Now remember, you can freeze at any time. Of course, if you make a mistake, now you're back to the base card, and Corinne gets a free chance. You want to go?
Yes.
Higher than a five. It's a six. Now you'll freeze it.
Yeah.
We'll move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away. You need just two, and you've kept Corinne away from her cards. Ellen, this time the question goes to you.
Okay.
We polled 100 fifth grade girls in Southern California, fifth grade girls, and asked them, do you support the women's liberation movement? How many fifth grade girls said they did?
I would say 75. Fifth grade girls are very progressive.
75, she says. Support the women's liberation movement.
Well, I think that's kind of young to be getting into it, so I think the number would be lower than that.
You say lower. The actual number of fifth grade girls who support the women's liberation movement is 46. It's lower. Corinne. And the rest of them support lollipops. Corinne, you'll take a look at your base card. It is a 10. You want to play it or change it?
I think I'd like to change it.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck. A 4. Good change.
Okay, I think the next card will be higher.
Higher than a 4. Oh, no. You lose that card. You give Ellen a free chance to play. Now, Ellen, you did not win the question. You must play off the 6. Call this.
Higher
than a 6. It is an 8.
Okay, lower.
Lower. This is lower. You've won the first game in the best 2 out of 3 match. For the win, you got it. Yay! With $100. Corinne, now you've got to make a comeback. Pressure's on the champion for the first time in a long time. Is she equal to it? We'll find out after this.
Let's Make a Deal Live is on its way. Join us for an all-new version of the classic game show. Like it on TV? You'll love it on stage. Let's Make a Deal Live. For ticket information, go to lmadlive.com.
All right, Corinne, this time the pressure's on. You said once before you did come from behind, though, right? Yeah, you have had to come from behind once, but you've been in the lead most of the time, I think. Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Most of the time.
Ellen has the first game at $100. Janice, if you will, deal out the cards. Same two decks of cards right off the top, and the question goes to you, Corinne. We asked 100 married women, have you ever found lipstick on your husband's collar? How many women said they had?
I don't think too many would have, or they wouldn't admit it. So I would say 20 said they had.
Have you ever found any on your...
No.
Yeah. How long have you been married, Corinne?
6 months.
Oh, that long. Of course. She says 20 out of 100 say they found lipstick on their husband's collar. Ellen, higher or lower?
I'm going to say it's a little bit higher.
You say higher.
Lipstick can get on collars. Easy.
Maybe just lipstick,
anybody's
right?
Anybody's lipstick.
The actual number of women who found lipstick on their husband's collar is... 13, it's not higher, Corinne. Here's your base card for this game, Corinne. It is a 7, do you want it?
Get rid of it.
Change it, get rid of it. It is an ace, big change.
Okay, the next card has got to be lower.
Lower than an ace. A king.
Oh. Okay, I'm going to continue and the next card will be lower.
Lower than a king. 5.
I'm going to keep going, and I think the next card will be higher.
You're risking both of these cards and this one. Higher than a 5. A queen! Got away with it.
Okay, I'm going to have to go for it, and the next card will be lower.
Trying to clear the board. If this is lower than a queen, we've got a tie match. It's a 7. She did it. Tied it up. Yeah, that was quick. Janice, if you'll set up for the tiebreaker. Corinne with $100, Ellen with $100. We go to the tiebreaker with just 3 questions and just 3 cards up there as we move the bar over. And the question as we left off, it goes to you, Ellen. Control, most important with just 3 cards up there. We polled 100 women and asked, who do you think are able to keep secrets better, men or women? How many women said they keep secrets better?
How many women say they keep secrets
better? That's right. How many women say women keep secrets better? 5 to some of the audience.
I'm going to say 30 women.
30. 30, ooh. What do you think, higher or lower, Corinne?
I think it would have to be a little bit lower than that.
You say lower. Lower, all right. I'll find out as you do. The actual number of women who said they keep secrets better is 33. It's not lower. Ellen, We've got that all-important control, and we'll look at that base card. You have a four.
Okay.
You want to play it or change it?
And it's going to be higher.
Higher than
please.
A four.
Please.
It is an eight. Difficult decision now, right up the middle, but you only need one card. You're going to freeze, needing just that one card. Corinne didn't get a chance at her cards, and we go with a question to you, Corinne. We asked 100 people in a previous studio audience, do you believe that some people have the power to read minds? How many people said yes? Tough question.
Well, I do. I think there are some people that might be able to read minds, so I would say 60 people.
60. 60. Six, do you say 60 or 16?
60.
60, 6-0. Mm-hmm. Okay. She says 60 out of 100 say they know people can read minds. Ellen, higher or lower?
People, that's so publicized now. I would say higher.
You say higher than that?
Higher than that.
The actual number of people who believe that some people can read minds is 63. You're right, Ellen.
Oh, it's high. Oh.
You want that
okay.
eight?
No, I don't want the eight.
No. She wants a jack.
Okay.
Ellen, this is for the win. Call this card.
Lower.
Lower. If this
Please
is lower, we have a new champion on Card Sharks. Lower than a jack. Lower than a jack. It is not lower. A break for Corinne. We look at her base card. It is a king.
Okay, the next card will be lower.
Lower than a king. A five.
Okay, I'm gonna go, and I think the next card will be higher.
If this is higher than a five, Corinne remains the champion for the win. It's a jack! You get it again! Making another great comeback. Corinne, you keep doing it. Congratulations. Ellen, you played very well. Just got a tough turn. Thank you. That's good. Thank you for joining us, Ellen. Come on down here, Corinne. My goodness, you keep winning. You're doing it well, and we'll get to the money cards once again where she can win thousands right after this.
Raver.
Hello there.
Dawson.
Survey said.
Two originals, 2 hours.
You gonna watch the telly tonight, are you?
Match Game and Family Feud today at 4.
All right, Corinne, here we go again. How many money cards is this now?
Oh, I think 5.
Well, you've been doing very well. You're over $15,000 in winnings. Are you ready to do it again?
Yeah.
Okay, ready. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on up there. Once again, you've got $200 in the game, and again, it's yours to keep. Now we've got a brand new deck, all shuffled and cut, and you're going to play with these cards here as we once again start with $200 at the bottom. You know three cards, and we'll go up to the second level. We add another $200, three more cards. There'll be a total of 7 up there, and it can add up to thousands of dollars if you can play them right, get the right cards, and good intuition. The big bet, that's the top card, and there you've got to bet at least half the money. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Let's double that money if we can. Here's $200 to start with. And once again, the choice of 2 base cards, Corinne, starting with a queen. You want to play that queen?
I think I'll keep that. And I'm going to bet $200 that the next card will be lower.
Lower than a queen. Whole thing, right off the bat. $200, lower than a queen. No, it's another queen. This happened before with the 4 with you. But again, you're not out of it because we're going to move that good card. It's still a good card, the queen, up here and give you $200 of betting money again. 4 cards to go. It can still add up. Let's do it.
Okay, I don't think it's going to happen again. So I'm going to bet $200 that the next card will be lower.
Lower. Let's not see another queen. $200, lower than a queen. It's a 10. All right. We're over that first hump. Now we go. $400 and a 10. What's your bet on this card?
Okay, I'm going to bet $200 that the next card will be lower.
Lower. $200, lower than a 10. It's a 5. Now you're going. $600 now with a 5.
Okay, I'm going to bet $400 that the next card will be higher.
$400. Two-thirds of it. $400 higher than a 5. Oh, no, it's a 3. Down to $200, but a good card here, the 3. We'll move it up. You've got to bet at least $100. You've got $200. It's a good card, the 3.
Okay,
you got money, Corinne.
I'll bet the whole thing that the next card will be higher.
Okay. The whole thing. $200. Higher than a 3. It better be higher. $200 higher than a 3. It's a 10, yeah. Another $400, Corinne. Your luck has changed on those money cards. You started out like a gangbuster, and now you float down. You know how much you've got so far?
No, I don't.
$15,800 on card charge.
Well, that's not too bad.
That's not too bad at all. That'll take you on that honeymoon. We will be bringing out a new challenger right after this.
Up next, contestants try to match wits with insane celebrities while Gene Rayburn tries to control it all on a buzzer double play of Match Game. Next, stay tuned.
Corinne, I thought you were going to break the bank with your first money cards, and you slowed down since then, but you keep winning. You ready to meet a new challenger?
Sure am.
Okay, let's bring her out right now. Come on out here, our next player on card chart. Chris, how do you pronounce your last name, Chris?
Maroney.
Nice to have you here. Why don't you tell us just a little about yourself?
Okay, I'm a married lady, and I'm here to win lots of money so we can put some fish in our new aquarium we just built, 100-gallon aquarium.
That's good. We've run out of time, but we wanted to get you out here and let you get comfortable and meet everybody, and we'll start your match as soon as we come back with you on Card Sharks. Thank you for joining us. Bye-bye.
One of our polling groups will receive Frigidaire's mobile dishwasher. Features a pots and pans cycle, 2 energy options, 5 levels, super surge washing action, and an adjustable upper rack for odd-sized items. And some of our contestants will receive Eureka's new ESP, extra suction power vacuum. 50% more power, more beating, brushing, and cleaning action, 6-way height adjustment Eureka. And ceilings by Celotex. Choose from a wide variety of patterns, colors, and textures. Also beautiful and easy to install, they enhance any room. And paperback books from Ballantyne, including The Luck Factor by Max Gunther. Good luck can be yours if you know how to get it from Ballantyne. And a selection of romper room toys featuring Tumbling Weebles to add more warmth, love, and laughter to your child's romper room years. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.